Hey, what is going on, guys? Welcome to the brand new Android app development tutorial series 1. So today we are going to learn about Android app development from the scratch to the professional level, and this is your host Sabith, and I will be taking you directly from nothing to something. So when I say nothing, I mean you don't need any kind of experience in any kind of programming languages, because everything is much way easier. Because when I learned, I don't even know how to change a text view and replace it with my name. So I will teach you all the things required to be a professional Android developer, and finally we'll be uploading our application into the Google Play Store. So let's get started. So I hope you guys have installed the Android Studio and also already with the JDK, that is the Java Development Kit. So let's get started. I'm gonna open my Android Studio. So if you have any trouble while installing the Android Studio, you can probably comment below this video and I'll be happy to serve you with the exact issue and the solution. So anyway, let's get started to the Android app development. So we have the Android Studio 2.3 because I'm using the latest version. So what you have to do is just click on the start a new Android Studio project. This is the button where you can navigate into a new Android application. So at the first, you can see here is the application name. I'm now giving it as sample or first app. So first app. In the company name, you have to give a package name. So probably you have seen many package names. We'll be discussing what is actually a package name after just installing the Android app in the Android phone or Android tablet devices. So let's keep it. I'm gonna giving it as, if you have a domain name, that is better just giving it as domain name. So in my case, I have the textetro.com. So I'm gonna giving it as textetro.com itself. So as you can see, the package name now turned into com.textetro.my application name, that is first app. So once we have done, just we have to set the project location. So in my case, I'm changing the project location into the main folder. So I'm using the root, the users slash my name or whatever else it is. You can use any location. You can even use the desktop for saving your project files. So I'm gonna use my name or my username. Now click the OK. So once you have selected all the things, you can press the next, where you can select the minimum SD duration. So here you can see I'm using Android version 4.2, that is Jelly Bean, that is API. In API version, it is called API 17. So the reason why we have to choose this API is because we have a lot of API 9 to we have API 25 right now available while I'm recording this video. So API 9 can only support a really small unit of Android Studio elements, but in case of API 25, you can use a lot of features that you can integrate into your Android apps. So in my case, I'm gonna go with the Android version 17 because this can almost support all the features required for a normal Android app. So if you have a Android device like Android 4.0, you can probably select this because we are not going to deal with a high-end elements inside the Android Studio. So you can even choose the Android for Android version 4.0, or you can go with lower versions also. So in my case, I'm gonna go with the Android version 4.2, that is API 17. So in you have to uncheck all these things because we are only going to design the Android app for the mobile or tablet devices. So next, what we have to do is just click the next. So once you have done, we have the option to select an activity which we need. So we have the no activity or basic activity, border navigation activity, empty activity, full screen activity, and a lot of other kind of activities are available. So what it actually means is that in the blank or empty activity, we get simply a window with an action bar. So this is called action bar. This thing is called action bar, and this is our area to do the work. So in a basic activity, you'll be getting an action bar with back button or menu, and here is a floating action button, and here are some of the activities that we'll be able to use in our Android app. So this is our first tutorial, so we're going to be going with the empty activity. I'm selecting this one, clicking the next. and now you can name the activity. So by default it is main activity and the layout name is activity main. So activity is a Java class and layout main is a XML file. We'll be discussing later on this video. So without any changing over this name, we're gonna be clicking the finish. Let's see what will happen now. So once it is done, we can see there is the Gradle is going to build your project. So everything is done by the Gradle because Android Studio also need the Gradle to for its smooth performance. So this loading depend upon what's your PC specifications. So if your PC have high power, or you can easy if it is a gaming PC, that will be really faster in building this file. So I'm gonna skip this setup. Okay guys, so we have successfully completed the Gradle build of the Android app. Now we have the Android app in the Android Studio. So this is the Android Studio framework where you can find a couple options over the top. We have different kind of tabs and we have the file edit, and same as we have seen in many other Android apps. So here we can see here is a button that is open, and we have the save, refresh, undo, redo, and cut, copy, paste, search, replace, and many other kind. So we have the run, we have AVD manager, Android virtual device manager, and here is the SDK standard development kit, and many other things around here. So at the top we have two different tabs, that is main activity.java and activity underscore main.xml. We have two different files already opened. So here is the project tab where we can navigate into different kind of files inside the project. Now we have the app folder is open. Here is the manifest. Inside that we have the Android manifest.xml. We have the Java where the classes files are kept in. So we have three different kind of folder. This is the folder that we require that has the main activity.java. And coming to the rest, which stands for resources, we have the drawable folder where we will be adding all the graphic files, and here is the layout folder where we can get the activity underscore main.xml file. So we have the mipmap where we are going to add the Android app icon, and under that we have the values folder which you can select the or you can adjust the theme of your Android app. So that is the colors.xml. We have the strings to change the application name. We have the styles to use different kind of styles or themes inside the Android app. So and finally we have the Gradle script main folder. We have many other things inside that we'll be discussing all these in the later coming tutorials. So without any further ado, let's get started to the work window or the window that we are coding our Android app. So this is the window. At the top we have the package name, and here is import which contains some of the libraries, pre-built libraries are introduced in the import, and we have the public class, main activity, extend activity, app compact activity, and some other Java codes. Now at the left side to the code, you can see here is the number of lines that we have used. That doesn't matter in our case. So let's move to the activity underscore main.xml. So now you can see here is a window where we can see Android app, just like how it look inside the Android device. So we have a text view, hello world. And before I'm getting into it, let me talk about the elements available here. So we can adjust the area we require for each activity. So this is the palette. This is the palette where we're going to be selecting all the widgets and other frame layouts and other things that we require for this activity to work on. So at the top we have the palette where we can navigate into special kind of items available. So I'm gonna go with the all, and all shows all the things inside it. So we have the blank area, but we're gonna be selecting a button. But if once we have selected the button, we can see the screenshot of how it look inside the Android app. We have the rating bar and many other things. If I am selecting the text view, you can see a text view over here. So here we can see a constrained layout, and inside that we have the text view. We'll be discussing all these in the coming section. So at the top we can see the layout we have two type of show the design. So we have two type of design can be shown. Now we have selected the both item. Now you can see here is a normal view and this is a constrained view. So you can only select the constrained, or you can go with the normal, or you can select the both at same time. So we're going to be going with the normal view, and we can adjust the size, or we can increase it, the screen size, or decrease it. And we have all other things available. We're going to be discussing all that in the coming section. So right now we have a constraint and layout. So next we're going to be going to at the bottom. We can see the text. We're going to be clicking that. Now we can see here are some of the codes. These codes are somewhat related to the HTML and the XML, which stands for expandable markup language, just like an HTML says that hypertext markup language. So now we have seen that it's already written some of the codes here. So if you want to see what the code actually do, you can always turn the preview on from the right side. Now you can also increase the preview size. Okay, now we can see here is a text view. I'm gonna go and delete this, and you can see the text view from here is disappeared. Now when I get it back again, you can see here is the text view again. Now that's what it actually is. So we're gonna be changing the text view. So as you can see here, you can see the Android colon text equal to hello world. No, we're gonna be changing it with, so now you can see I have changed the Android text equal to hello world into Android text equal to my first app. So you can see the changes at the same time over here, but some of the widgets may not show the changes inside the preview section at the same time, but you can find the changes definitely by running the app in your Android device. Okay, now let's move to the design again. You can see when I select my first app, that is a text view, when I select this text view, you can see some of the lines over here, 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 and downwards. So this represent the X and Y directions of this text view inside this area. So we're gonna be going with relative layout, or let me show you. So the constrained layout is for only for experts who know how to develop an Android app completely without any kind of issues or doubts. So for this case, we're gonna be going to replace the constrained layout with relative layout or linear layout. I'm gonna go with the relative layout. So I'm gonna type relative layout. Now as you can see, the text view has been gone to this side. So at this time, we have replaced the constrained layout with relative layouts so that we have to remove codes up to here. So there is no changes after I'm removing these codes. Now let's replace the Android layout width, which adjusts the width of this widget, that is a text view. I'm gonna change it into match parent. So there are three types of available: width and height, that is match parent, wrap content, and the fill parent. So now I move the wrap content into match parent, and as a result you can see the width is adjusted from this, the starting to the ending of this blank screen. Now I'm gonna change the height also into match parent, and as you can see, this would just take all the areas inside this blank activity. So now we have even we have changed all the things, we can see the text view is just kept at the starting point or at the top left corner. So we're going to be changing the text view into the center. So all we have to do is add a new line which says Android, then gravity into center. Now once we have added, we can see the text directly jump from here to the center of the blank activity. So therefore we have a text view at the center. Now let's go to the design, and we are going to be selecting the text view. So here is a constrained layout has been replaced with the relative layout, and here is the text view. So I'm selecting the text view, and at the properties we can see a couple of options. We have changed the wrap content into match parent, we have the text and their descriptions, appearance, font family, which we can select the different kind of fonts, typeface, text size, and many other things. We're going to be selecting the text size. Let's replace it with 36. And now you can see the text view have changed into a larger one. So you can experiment with all the different kind of options available here. So I hope you have understood something in this series. And if you like this video, definitely give it a big thumbs up. For more videos, you can subscribe to my channel. If you have any kind of troubles while installing Android Studio or setting up the things, you can probably comment below this video and I'll be happy to serve you with the solutions. So thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Peace out. Stay, it will turn it on, going on, going thing.